I've chosen this location because everything you can see behind me was not here 18 years ago, and I didn't plant any of it. It planted itself. 18 years ago, this was a pasture. And I decided on this slope to leave everything from this ridge track that I created, the ridge track, well, I kept it clear, everything from here to the next valley, from this ridge to the next valley, all the way from top to bottom, right the way through Zaytuna Farm. I was not going to touch it. I was not going to graze it. I was not going to slash it. I could see small trees were coming up, and they were coming up from a little bit of older growth forest on this side of me. And this is the prevailing wind. So what's happened is a lot of this is native species, but quite a lot of it is not native species. It foreign species from interstate, not just outside of Australia, but Queenslanders in New South Wales. Queensland's a state north of us, North Queenslanders actually, and quite a few what we call invasive species, which may be the salvation of Earth, as Fred Pearce calls them in the great book, The New Wild. So this is not a native ecosystem that's planted itself. It's a novel ecosystem, including non-native and native, and the wildlife love it. I mean, they've been involved in the process, actually, bringing in seed. So this is hands-off for me. I didn't do this, it did itself. And I love it, actually. I think it's very beautiful. And the conservationists love it, especially when I went for approval for our new property shares, where we're dividing the property into 8 shares. We needed to have planted a few thousand trees to get permission to, or allowed a few thousand trees to grow. And this gave me permission for the development of the shared property. But I didn't actually do it. I allowed nature to do it itself. So this is interesting. So I'm going to take a couple of shots here. I'm going to talk here, and I'm going to go to a food forest system that I definitely planted myself and show you the difference. So Joanna says, watching course content on how well-established ecosystems work together, I wonder about introducing so many new exotic species to what is already working so well on its own. I understand the benefits of hard-working immigrants, but aren't they missing the allies and associates that exist to aid them in their native ecosystem? Doesn't tipping the native ecosystem more out of balance with more severe changes break the existing ecosystem and obscure what we would learn from it? While there are benefits to man-made ecosystem, to a man-made ecosystem, why not work with natives first? Do we have responsibility to use the smallest possible deviations from the native ecosystem needed to achieve our goals? Well, you possibly could look at it that way. Should there only be indigenous North American Indians in America, or are the non-North American natives welcome with all their diversity and all their actual wealth of culture? Are we better off isolating ourselves into our own origins as people, or is it better to share knowledge with lots and lots of people working together? That's how ecosystems work. Do we take the carrots back to Afghanistan where they originated, and the tomatoes to the Andes, and the potatoes as well, and not work with those crops? You know, and the same with our fruit trees. Australia has no native species that have been domesticated. Only the macadamia nut, which is native in this area, but has been developed to be a very productive nut, but and performs quite differently to the native nut. And its cultivated form probably wouldn't survive out in the native system. But that was developed in America, not by people in Australia, and we grow it here now as a commercial crop. But there are no food crops and no animals that have been domesticated, no plants that have been domesticated in Australia apart from the macadamia nut. And this landscape has never had an ice age. So it's interesting that permaculture started here on the flattest and driest and oldest landscape continent on this planet, which has never had an ice age and never domesticated any species much except for the macadamia. And we've imported more than any other continent. We've imported more plants and animals. And we've done more damage with less people over more area in less time than anybody in history. So those are the facts. But the reality is we're finding that novel ecosystems, which include native and non-native, come into a wonderful balance and a greater diversity than often the original ecosystems, which I'm fully in favor of. But I can't eat out of here. I might be able to hunt a few things, but there's nothing much I can eat on the ground. There's nothing much I can eat out of the trees. But there's wildlife in here. I'd have a job to hunt enough to eat in this area. I'd need a much larger area. But a cultivated area where I've designed the forest is full of food and takes up very little area at all. But the birds that are here go to the system that I created as well. They have no prejudice, they have no assumptions, they have no preconceived requirements of what nature is and how what nature works. They work with the novel ecosystems. So yes, we have to be careful to preserve what we've got, but there's massive areas that, like this was just pasture, and most of the grass here was not native. It was pasture grass brought in to graze cattle. Now there are a lot of native grasses that have moved in here, and some of them are even rare and endemic to this area. I didn't do that. They moved themselves in to this novel ecosystem that self-assembled. Let's go and have a look at what our oldest food forest looks like after 18 years. So you got 18 years of this. Here is a food forest that we did plant. This was all bare soil. When we did the earthworks for the pond over here next to the house, this was completely bare. In fact, the machinery, the bulldozer and excavator running across this. We planted our first assembly of species here, which included an enormous volume of volunteer work from lots of people, putting in a learning experience, putting in all the support species, massive numbers of support species. And they've cycled out of the system. There's very few of those support species left. And now there's nearly 20 varieties of fruit tree. They're all growing well together as an ecosystem, but there's only four or five that are actually native, and they're what we call bush tucker. They're not fully domesticated yet. There is a macadamia in here. There are plum pines, Davidson plum, peanut tree. They're native species that are being developed, and we're trialing some. We're getting some pretty good results. There are native timbers here. Some are actually endemic to this area. Others come from other parts of Australia. And most of the other fruit trees, all of the other fruit trees, they're from all over the world. They're internationals. And there are international long-term support species in here as well. But this system is an ecosystem designed for us, to our benefit. It's also a nursery where many little trees germinate on the floor, on the forest floor, but they don't grow to full height. They're dwarfated because all the space is taken up. It's a complete spatial relationship here. But you can transplant them out. We can intensely maintain this with very, very little work. One day a year, we keep this in quite intense maintenance. And we can be quite casual. You could do a little bit of maintenance every week if you really wanted to. Or you could walk away from this for 10 years with no maintenance, just abandon it. And with just one or two people with sharp, sharp tools could bring this into maintenance in one day. Like 1 acre, one day with no more than two people and sharp tools. And we just take the stretch out of it and pull it back down as chop and drop to the ground and support the system back into a flush of extra production. So the wildlife love it. They're no problem. They have no prejudice about that ecosystem or this ecosystem. People love it. They feel it like it's like the Garden of Eden. We can have these systems anywhere. We can have combinations like this, and the ecosystem function is probably higher here than it is in the one that planted itself. But it's definitely better for people, and it's a wonderful classroom. It's a wonderful place where so many people have learnt what it's like to be inside one of these and feel the productive energy of the system.